All right, so I want to go through our informative. If we have reds on this, I will include a reassess if you want to do that. If you have all greens, no need to reassess. So we have a gun that shoots a plastic ball or something like that. It has a spring in it. Spring-loaded toy gun launches a 20-gram toy ball. Ignore any dissipated energy and determine the velocity of the ball as it flows through the equilibrium position. So equilibrium position means that we no longer have a spring that has any compression to that. Okay, so we're going to want to have the spring because we know that we have elastic energy, and we're also going to have the ball. Okay, so compressed spring, that should be pretty obvious, elastic energy. And then it's all going to be moved into motion. So that's going to then change this to kinetic energy. The more complex you make it, the harder the problem is going to be. Like if you did a work like a W with an arrow going in, that's not wrong. But we don't have a model for solving for working, so that's not going to be that effective for you. Okay, so there is our sentence, and that's what your first part should look like. All right, so we are trying to find the velocity. Information they give us, the K value. 44 newtons per meter, mass is 0.02 kilograms, and they have stretch of the spring, so here's what the delta is for. Delta x of the spring equals 0.12 meters. All right, so plan, explain, step. Alright, so we're going to work backwards. So, velocity comes from our EK formula. Which is 1/2 mv squared. Okay, so we have the mass, we just need to find the EK, and we know from right here, EK equals ELS, so we need the ELS formula, and ELS is 1/2 K delta X squared. All should be your formulas, should have those on there. All right, so step. Square that. So if you do that, I'm not going to use my calculator from my computer because that is not fun to use. All right, we get 3.9168. And this should come out to be, meters cancel out, so one of the meters cancels out, so it's Newton times meters, which are also joules. Energy is always going to be in joules, remember, from our joules activity. Okay, so EK then is that same number. So this thing is 0.02 kilograms. Multiply that times the velocity, which we don't know. So you're going to take the 3.9168. You're going to divide that by 0.02. You're going to divide that by 1/2. And then take the square root of the answer. And you should get... And I should have what the answer would be, but they're going to be meters per second.